Welcome to Eurospeedway Lotsitz and Lotsitz, Germany. This is going to be the second and final oval of the European Tour here in Germany. It was also a one-off race, so there was 5 part-time cars other than the 4 that already had signed up. 5 more teams brought their part-time cars to add for a 6th race. However, Trek Tauger and Kenny Myatt took the final 2 spots on the grid. They qualified somewhere in the middle of the field, both of them. Eurospeedway Lotsitz, it's actually a little bit slower than other times we've been here. Speeds are right around 200 miles an hour, as the cars are becoming much more of a handling... As this track has become much more handling-based, it's still going to be a pack race, but it will be a, handling race as well, where your car has to be handling pretty well through these corners because of the relative lack of banking. This track will also give us a nice look to see what's going to happen in the American 700, our biggest race of the season, because this track, if anything, out of all the races at the start of the season, this, and, well, not even really Oklahoma, but this track is probably the closest to the Fontana Auto Club Speedway, which the American 700 is contested on, so this will be a nice test to see what happens in this race. What could happen in the American 700? Kenny Myatt, one of the guys out here, still says it's the most dangerous track that we've raced on all season. He went as far to call it stupidly fast. A lot of drivers don't really care for Eurospeedway, but the 60 laps around this track could prove to be a very aggressive one. Charles Jackson will be in the 18 car for injured Noah Hart. Nick Pericles was flown in to drive the pilot the 12 car. And Kazuki Takamoto will be in the 96 car for the suspended Chris Livier, who caused both those incidents. Alex Allen will be out through Bakernike, which is the next round in Latvia. And Noah Hart's expected to come back for the round of Colorado at Pikes Peak. Let's get down to the race, because it should be a thrilling one. Before we even get going, Casey Lester and one of the Menervinis did not go on the start. We are green, though, however, here at the round of Germany. Jake Baskinger leads DJ Curtis and Vincent Allen to the green. Looks like James Shelley slided the outside line. That was Zachary Fitzwater and the Menervini that didn't go. Down the backstretch he goes, entering turn number two. Down they go, entering turn number 2. This track is very, very risky, and you've got to be very risky to make moves on it. Here they go, entering turn number 3, the final of the 3 corners here. Looks like Vincent Allen's going to try and take the lead away from Jake Baskinger, but that's not going to happen there. A little bit further back, we've got James Silverfox. He won his first ever ARCSOA Elite Series race at the Eurospeedway Lotsitz. His home race, so he's definitely looking to put on a show for all of his fans here. Another team that's looking to do well here is the Marion Shawrot, Nick Pericles team. Of course, the Alex Allen's injured and out on injury, so Nick Pericles is in his car. Shawrot's in her home race as well. Going to be one of those races where they're going to have to watch out. There's Richard Johnson in the 6 car. Oh, big crash! I see the 94 got in it. That's Jessica Shelton, and I believe the other one was Charles Jackson, who's in for the injured Noah Hart. No caution for that. They kept it green. No caution. The SCS regular Charles Jackson, I think, just got into the quarter panel of the 94, and into the wall he went. Tough break for Charles Jackson in his ARCSOA Elite Series debut. He's not out of it yet, but he's got some heavy damage. Sam Curtis is charging on the inside with help from Tristan Willoyd, his part-time championship commanderate. And it looks like Willoyd's going to make the move to the inside lane to take the lead. Here comes the 2 Oricoms. This is Oricom's home race, we believe, here in Germany. R.L. Reeves, who, I'm not sure what Gideon Oldenfield is, where he's from, but I believe this is Oricom's home race, not sure though. On the inside, here comes R.L. Reeves, who Oricom's had a fantastic run here. They got Trek Tauger into the race as the second car, the one My Tauger got in for a sixth part-timer race. However, Trek Tauger's a long way down the order. Struggling with that car a bit. Kenny Myatt in the 09 is up the order in 15th position. And he's working with the McLaren of Eddie Shimpad car to get up the order as well. Looks like Sam Curtis continues to lead here at Eurospeedway Lodzitz. Here comes R.L. Ryusu with help from James Silverfox to the front of the field. Pushing along Belgium winner Tristan Wilhoit. And here they come. Looks like Ryusu's going to try and take the lead here. Looks like Baskinger's trying to get a run going with maybe the 23 car. Except it looks like now they're going four wide. That's really aggressive there with James Shelley on the inside. Baskinger could have gotten dumped there. They're coming up on the slow Charles Jackson car. This could be a site of some controversy here. Oh god, he's really slow. He's doing only about 160 when everyone's doing 190. Looks like Silver Fox in the outside lane is going to get held up. And Silver Fox is holding up the middle line. Oh boy, that was close there. We're looking at Jackson now. Jackson's going to have this SCS car for a while. There goes Myatt around, and we got the big one, maybe. But two of the Mercedes are in it. Lamas is in it. Doesn't look like there's a whole lot of damage, but from that wreck. Oh, there's the biggest hit there. That looked like the 96 of Kazuki Takamoto getting into the back of Richard Johnson. And Johnson didn't even have a whole lot of damage from that. Sean Angel leads them back. James Shelley second, Alan Cavagnaro third, Kenny Myatt fourth. I'm sorry if I said that was Kenny Myatt that went around. I believe that was Nathan McCain that went around. It looks like when they came up to Jackson, McCain was on the outside of the line there. And just some contact in the back here. The whole field checks up and looks like maybe Shock got into it there. No. Oh, it was Fabrosis that got up into the 9. Then the entire field just panicked, it looked like. Here it is from a better cam here. Wilhoit would get involved. There's the other FBR, excuse me, of Jacob Hart. Got in it. Takamoto. McCain's been going around a bit. Padcar's in it. Richard Johnson. Lamas. Bad run for him in the CBM race. Oh, big problems for one of the Mercedes United cars there. Yeah, this is what happened to Nick Pericles. We're going to go on board with him as this wreck takes place. Wreck happens in front of him. Pericles spins out. Tries to regain control. He does. But he's in the grass, and he's trying to keep it under control and try and get back on the track because he doesn't have all... Oh, no, he's not trying to get back on the track and drives it into the pit wall. Man, that official was lucky to jump out of the way when he did. During the pit stop cycle, DJ Curtis was the only car to stay out. Kind of surprising there as Sean Angel came in and everybody else did. Casey Lester came back out on track. He is a couple laps down. The cars out so far. Jessica Shelton, Takamoto, Lamas, and I believe somebody else fell out. But so only four cars went out after that wreck, so that's kind of impressive if I do say so myself. McCain's in it, Johnson's still in it, Richard Johnson in his, he raced in Elites way back in the day, back in, season 10-ish, 11-ish, 9-ish, somewhere in there, and he actually won a race at Fontana, so Richard Johnson does have ARCSOA Elite Series experience. However, coming to the restart, DJ Curtis would develop a tire rub, and, would have to come down pit road. Coming to the restart, some problems for DJ Curtis. Kind of a tough break for him because I thought with him up there, he could have been a serious threat for this because he's kind of great on these kinds of tracks that are high speed. Remember, he won the American 700 back when it was at Texas Motor Speedway. That's going to promote Sean Angel to the lead with Alan Cavagnaro in second. Cavagnaro had a very quick pit stop. The Ferrari boys did. Green flag is back out again, and we are off. It looks like Charles Jackson's going to get way out of the way. He's at least being somewhat respectful. He's holding a line. He picked the inside line, and, well, Silver Fox was stupid for leading everybody down there. And now, I don't know why Silver Fox and them aren't going around him. Now it looks like Ryusu's looking to. No, I'm sorry, that's Delice, but they're looking to. But I'm really getting concerned now because Jackson's trying to stay out of the way, and nobody's wanting to pass him. Oh, boy, there's a little bit of contact there. There goes
I see Thanos is over. Oh, man. Nelson's flipping massively down the track. Oh, Fabrosis is upside down. Zeb Stark's in it. Tauger's in it. So we're going to get another caution. What happened was, I think Thanos... No, it was... 21 pushed 24 up there and... up into the pack and, well, 24 and the 1 went over. Nice avoidance by Zeb Stark and a couple other drivers there. On board with Trek Tauger. You'll see how quickly this race can turn and, no, actually, I think he kind of caused it. He got up into the Thanos car. Into Thanos and flipped everybody and started that one. So that was actually Tauger's bad there, but Tauger would get out of that all right. Better than Nelson, at least. I believe Nelson will fall out after this wreck. During the pit strategy, during the caution, Alan Cavagnaro would develop a problem with his Ferrari. We believe this isn't going to be terminal, but he is... it is terminal! Cavagnaro's out! He has a serious mechanical problem. They're pushing that one behind the wall, so tough break for Alan Cavagnaro. This was by far the best run he's had all season. Once again, the field, though, we'll have to deal with Charles Jackson again. Jackson, like I said, was being respectful. He was holding a line, but then kind of slid up the track. But Silver Fox didn't. I think that was actually unintentionally Silver Fox's fault for not passing, for not taking the line around him, because he was waving them by, and he doesn't do anything. And Silver Fox didn't do anything with it. Sean Angel once again leads on the restart. We'll see what happens with Charles Jackson again. He dives low, but I'm not sure why any of these guys are going to try down low. Myatt knows better than this. Luckily, I think the back of the field got held up by a mechanical problem by somebody. Oh, wait, we had a caution back there. Man, we can't even get a lap in. Yeah, Sean Galligan broke down on the start when he accelerated, and that made everybody pack up behind him. And there was a little bit of contact. Oh, wow, it looks like Tauger got up on two wheels there. McCain's in it. Jacob Hart's got more damage. And Zeb Stark got in it. A lot of cars that were already in wrecks because of Sean Galligan breaking down. Under that caution, Sean Galligan would fall out due to an engine, and DJ Curtis would fall out for a gearbox issue. That's why he had to come in. Apparently, that wasn't a tire problem. But Sean Angel would lead again on this restart. We're going to look back again. Where all the issues are going to be. Myatt once again is looking low, but yeah, this one's more on Charles Jackson. He needs to kind of get out of the way that time, but he is looking like he's holding a line up on the outside. If he stays up there, I think they'll get away all right. He's going to hold up cars no matter what, but now he's getting up onto the high line safely. Whoa, they're in the grass. Oh, problem for Ike Durbin. Couple of cars have issues. R.L. Ryusu, Ike Durbin, Paula Thanos, and Tyler Thaber, they all got caught speeding under the car, or no, passing cars before the yellow, before the caution lights, or before the green flag wave. So they had to come in for penalties. A little bit further up, we're noticing Cooper Cyron, who's been an oval master his entire career, is up there along with the two Porsches in their home race. A Baskinger and Angel. Vincent Allen's up there. His teammate fell out. The lap car of Casey Lester, Matt Duncan. Kenny Myatt's actually catching the top six. Bernier, Silver Fox. There's Ike Durbin coming out of the pits as we're going back a little further. This is kind of what we want to see as a spread out thing where they're not constantly piled on top of each other. Thanos and Ryusu did not have penalties. I mind you, only Ike Durbin did. Thanos had a... mechanical problem, as does Ryusu, so both cars are having a lot of mechanical problems in this race. This track hasn't been easy on the engines because of the relative high RPMs around this track. Single file racing, we're looking at James Shelley, though, trying to take the lead. We thought at Belgium he might be able to get his first win. Maybe Eurospeedway will be the track he gets it. Maybe. Here's Kenny Myatt, the leading part-timer car. Myatt has had a pretty poor start to his part-time championship. Hasn't had the best finishes. However, this could be strong for him because we have not seen the sixth race that he got himself into is going to be important, I think, for him. He qualified in, and now he's running fifth. He's going to get an extra race practically on everybody else. And part-timers can be in Tauger will. They're saying that they might do another one where they have everybody fighting for it. Here is the secondary pack led by Nathan McCain, Tuomas Saarinen. This is for the final point spot, by the way. Tristan Wilhoit, I believe Richard Johnson's in it. Trek Tauger, and it looks like that's Kyle Schock Jr. Eddie Shimpadkar's back here. Ike Durbin, who had the penalty. And we're a little bit further back. We're looking at a couple other cars. James Shelley's trying to fight for the lead. He's been cycling it with the two Porsches ever since the start of this race. So this could be, like I said, I'm actually feeling confident that James Shelley could actually win this race if he doesn't blow it up. Timur Dalis and Sam Curtis are entering this pack now, as Charles Sanford and a few other guys. The pack seems to be growing because of the way that the draft works here. Once again, Jake Baskinger now to the bottom to take the lead. Here comes Kenny Myatt. Myatt's actually been pretty strong here in the past, but past races here, but has never really had the luck to solidify it here. Myatt could be on, of course, for a win here. James Silver Fox is also in the lead pack. He won the last time we were here. Silver Fox did. I would expect good things out of James Silver Fox as this race goes on. Great to see James Silver Fox this far up the grid. He's had a long string of bad luck here. Look at that McLaren down there. I believe that's Nicolas Vergnier. Vergnier is having an awesome race as well here. As he says, James Shelley and Vincent Ellens fall into the back of this pack. Jacob Hart has now assumed his teammate Charles Jackson's position as the slowest car on track. The pack is actually catching him, led by the two Porsches. Porsche has been dominant here. Kind of surprising because Porsche doesn't seem to have the engine power, but this track has come down to more of a handling race. And so Jake Baskinger and Sean Angel are doing an awesome job today in their Porsche cars. Here they come up to Jacob Hart. Looks like the inside line is going to get a bit of an advantage here. No, Jacob Hart's not just going to be a very good back marker. In fact, he's going to let the inside go. And this is kind of what we're worried about, is when this gets packed up like this. Oh boy, Baskier's got to back off. I thought he was going to dump the 19 there into the 09 and the 91. But now we got a big pack for the lead. Charles Jackson will be a problem now. And I'd say pretty much anybody in this pack could have a threat to win it. Both DNCs are now in this pack. Cooper Siron was kind of there, but hasn't had anybody really to work with. Charles Jackson now. Sean Angel, he's holding a line. He's been a very respectable back marker for the most part, except for one restart where he really wasn't. He's holding a line and doesn't really even slow up the pack all that much. He just gets a couple of the cars on the outside, both DNCs and both on the one McLaren of Nicolas Vergnier. And he's relatively getting out of the way from them too. Charles Jackson's being a much better backmarker than his teammate. Vincent Allen and James Shelley are now pushing each other to the lead now, or Shelley's pushing Allen to the lead. There will be another slow car of Zeb Stark up there. James Shelley would cycle to the lead as he pits for fuel, obviously. He takes Vincent Allen and James Silver Fox down pit road with him. Everybody else in the lead pack stays out. With the two Porsches, Tamer DeLeese was up to third. Good job by DeLeese in the Oricom. We're going to be seeing if what pit strategy's better, personally. All right, here they come. We'll see who's coming in this time. Looks like the Porsches are staying out. Looks like Samper looked to pit, but only car coming off pit road is going to be Zeb Stark, who's a lap down. Oh, no, now they're coming in. Oh, but they missed it. Oh no, that's because Sam Curtis is broken down! Sam Curtis has broken down and split the pack up! That's gonna kill Myatt, Duncan, Cross, Vergnier, and Sanford's races there for a little bit unless they get a caution. Now, if I am just pitting, like James Shelley, a couple others. You better not hope for a caution here. You better not have... better hope that Sam Curtis makes it around, or else they're in trouble. Or else they're in big trouble. Sam Curtis would make it around. The only car to stay out by the next time around would be Jake Baskinger. Baskinger stayed out. He's begging for a caution. He's coming in now, though. Sirens came in, but Sanford is pitting with him. Cross looks like he's maybe doing another run here. Cross is great on fuel mileage a lot of times, so... Cross, I think, is becoming the big star in AES competition. Andrew Cross is. Cross is going to be, I think, a future champion in this series, as he's coming down to only about 20 to go. He'll pit. He's going to be by far the clear leader here. But he's all by himself, and he's begging off, biting draft off of other cars. A little bit further back, I believe James Shelley is the clear second place man, if I'm not mistaken. Might actually be Cooper Siren, but... Cross is staying out again! Cross would finally pick, coming to lap 42. And Andrew Cross is on pit road. Now is going to be the challenge to see where, in fact... in fact had the better strategy. On pit road also is Nathan McCain. Cross has a clear pit road. This pit road can be quite tight as well, so clear pit road may be better. Tuomas Saarinen is somehow in third position, or no, I don't think he is. Never mind. I gotta see who's in the lead. Tristan Willhoy took the lead as he's coming in late now. He came in later than Cross did. So he's coming down pit road. Oh, we got problems for one of the fours. Oh no, Cross has a problem! No, he doesn't, never mind. Nearly got lapped by Willhoyt there. Not sure exactly who's in the lead right now. 14 to James Shelley has a virtually unopposed lead right now over Jake Baskinger, Tamara DeLise, Sean Angel, who looks like he's breaking down. Casey Lester, who's a lap down. Nicholas Vernier and Charles Hipper, I thought, Angel. Oh, Angel does have a problem. So Angel has a tire going down, it looks like, and he's got a pit. So the clear leader right now is James Shelley with only a handful of laps to go over Baskinger and DeLise. And then Vernier, Sanford, and then sixth is Kenny Myatt. James Shelley has never won an ARCSOA Elite Series race, and this is the most commanding lead I've seen him have here at Eurospeedway Lausitz Ring. However, he is being reeled in by the drafting brigade of Tamara DeLise and Jake Baskinger. Sean Angel, one of the late pit stop men. Actually, one of the early pit stop guys, had a tire issue and has to come down pit road and pit. DeLise and Baskinger are busy battling with each other. DeLise thinks he can be better leading this pack. I don't know if that's a wise thing to do. I don't think it is. But right as James Shelley was actually pulling away from a pack, the caution would fly for debris. So now James Shelley has to survive a restart. Oh, this will be interesting. However, lucky for James Shelley, it's a single file restart. Kyle Schott Jr.'s a lap car, and Jacob Hart, who's been drastically slow, is in between him in second position. If Baskinger can play a bit of a game here, Shelley could win this. However, you've got Tamara DeLise back there, Sean Angel, and Charles Sanford. James Shelley, this is probably the best I've ever seen him with a chance to win this. He's had the dominant car of the day with only a handful left to go. Green flag is out here at Eurospeedway Lausitz. Already looks like Baskinger's making a move down low to get by Sanford, or to get by Hart. Everybody's diving low to get by him. Sean Angel wants to see a caution, and I think they got a caution, yes! Paula Thanos broke! So now, James Shelley has to survive only one more quick dash restart. As they race back to the line, I don't think they'll catch him. Looks like Samper's getting a push from Stink by Nicolas Vernier. Vernier wants to win a race this season. Looks like Samper's going to take second. And something happened with Paula Thanos. Yeah, Thanos is blowing up here, and he comes. And Thanos comes right across Silver Fox's nose. There's Eric Silver Fox getting a piece of it. James Silver Fox and Eric Silver Fox for the other two involved in it. And Thanos would fall out, as would Eric Silver Fox. When they go back green, it'll be a three-lap dash for cash. If a caution comes out, the race will end, obviously. Let's race back to the line. James Shelley and Charles Samper have never won a race, followed by Sean Angel, who is a lap down. Oh, problems for the Oricom of Delice. Delice has to come down pit road, and he's not going to make pit road. It's going to be a problem for him. The top three have never won a race, and Kenny Myatt is the second winningest driver in ARCSOA. There's a bit of a discrepancy going on in the back. Green flag is out. Shelley didn't get a good start. Oh, one of them. Oh, Audis is done. We might only get a one-lap dash here. They might tow the car off. That's Casey Lester. He's had mechanical problems from the start of this race. Shelley leads. No caution. They got the car. They're pushing the car quickly back off to the side. Nicolas Vernier and Samper are battling for second. This could finally be the day for one of these three drivers up front, but here comes Kenny Myatt, the winningest driver in ARCSOA. Or the second winningest, most championships there. I don't think Myatt's gonna fight. I think Myatt's gonna fight tooth and nail for this, but it's Shelley and Vernier with two to go. Shelley has had the car to beat all day. Right now, I can't believe what I'm seeing. James Shelley's 1.5 laps away from taking the checkered. Looking further back, no sign of a caution, so we are gonna get a finish here. What do you actually, Baskin was looking for something there. Final lap for James Shelley. I can't believe I'm seeing this, but it's gonna be down to the final lap. Can anybody get a run? Nicolas Vernier and Myatt. Myatt's looking to take second. They're four wide for third. They're four wide for fourth. They're not going to get anything there. It's going to be one of these top three. Vernier, Myatt, or Shelley. Turn two now. James Shelley's finally going to get to... He's only got a half lap to go before it's possible. First win. Final turn. It looks like this is finally the day. James Shelley comes to the final turn. He's coming down to the checkered. It's been the most second place finishes without a win, but James Shelley finally erases that. He finally wins an ARCSOA Elite Series race here at the Eurospeedway Lausitz. Myatt's throwing his hand out to congratulate him. I almost cannot believe that I've seen this. James Shelley has finally won an ARCSOA Elite Series race. Third's gonna go to Nicolas Vernier. The 14 car finally's done it. He's got to be emotional now. He's waited so long for a win. He's doing a victory lap. What a showing there. He had one of the most successful drivers in ARCSOA Elite Series chasing him down right at the end of it. James Shelley finally won it. Let's go down to your finishing results.